Hey everybody, this is LEGO Star Wars Encounter on Jakku set based on some of the scenes from The Force Awakens. Highlight of the set for me is definitely this Lugga Beast here, which I think looks great. It's brighter in colors than what you saw in the movie, but I can't think of any color that LEGO has in their inventory or their color palette that would have been more appropriate, especially with the blue. That's a dark azure there, so a bunch of pieces that were not available previously in dark azure, including some relatively new molds with the small 2x2 wedge pieces. It just looks really cool. It is mostly brick built, and then they just add on some animal legs on the sides. You can pose those. There's some friction in there. They actually ratchet the joint, so you can kind of make it look like it is walking along pretty easily. And it just remains stable at all times. You know, it has all the stability you could possibly ask for from this style of animal, and just makes it look good. You can also bring the head up level like so. So it's flat. So it kind of looks like it's more attentive and looking forward. Like, wait, what's going on? Where are we going? We're going over there. Okay, fine. Yeah, a nice level of detail with some greebling on the front, including the black roller skate piece that they used here, just for a little extra texture. The eyes, if you will, the whole piece right here is just a printed piece. And that's an inverted tile piece, so it's actually three-dimensional. It's convex, sticks out a little bit, one of those on either side. It was enjoyable to build. It's solid, it's very poseable, it's very displayable, has a nice level of detail, yet it still looks very LEGO. You know, they're not ashamed of the studs that are readily apparent on the thing. You can put a figure on it very easily. Has the little wrapped up blanket behind there, kind of simulated with a couple of studs on either side of a modified plate, I think, with the, you know, the extension on the side. And yeah, I'm just really happy with this thing. It's definitely the main reason to get the set for me. And then this is part of the marketplace that featured heavily in the movie, where Unkar Plutt does his purchases and exchanges and such. I like the plastic piece, this vinyl piece that's used as a little bit of covering there, a little bit of awning. It has a nice print on it. You know, it's not too realistic, it has a little bit of comic style to it, but that's pretty standard for LEGO. And the coloration is nice. Doesn't look so great from this side, unfortunately. This is where you can come up to the window. You can see Unkar Plutt inside of there, but yeah, it's just not the most camera friendly angle. Got a little spot over here with a place where you can pick up some tools. So we've got a push broom there. This is a golden crowbar piece. And then there's also, you already saw there, an extra droid arm. You can use that droid arm there with this old rusted up battle droid here. And I like the kind of barred up windows on this side, and there's a tool there for doing some more work. And you got just a little more built up over here, and you notice there's a pair of droid legs. So you can actually complete that droid with the parts in this set. I appreciate that very much. Kind of gets you a bonus figure, if you will. And the whole thing also opens up to give you access to the inside. There's a little bit of detailing on the inside. So there's just a weapon, and this is kind of the cash drawer or safe. So there's a bunch of money inside of there with the gold coins. One thing that's missing though is the rations. So they don't have anything included for representing the bread or whatever that seaweed alga stuff is. I really would like to have seen some at least dark green tile pieces. Now there is a little bit of a secret storage compartment, which is pretty nicely integrated. You rotate this around, it acts as a lock, and then all of this slides out. A little tray, which has just a small pistol hidden down under there. That's nice. You know, it's not a lot of space, but it's a good use of the elevated platform. You know, the whole surface of most of this shop is elevated up, so it leaves open space underneath, and they've used some of that space, and it's hidden away pretty nicely. This figure selection is nice also. Unkar Plutt on the left there is brand new, and most of what makes him is just one piece that fits over a traditional unprinted minifigure body. So all of this comes off, and this is just a printed piece that has all of his exclusive coloration on it. It's just a two-colored piece with the gunmetal gray and the dark tan, and then all the flesh tone and everything else is just painted or printed on. It's a little bit on the shiny side. I wish that the material that they used for the printing for the flesh tone was a little bit more matte. To his left, to the right for us, this is Tito, who rides the Lugabeast and was seen on the one scene that had the Lugabeast, notably in the movie. And that's a great looking figure by virtue of the head, which is a new mold. And that also uses two colors of plastic. So they've got the gunmetal gray going there, and then they've got the olive green, two different colors of plastic that are mixed together or molded together into one. And then Rey is nothing new, and BB-8 is nothing new, but they definitely make sense to be included in this set. All these have prints on the backs, and Rey still has her alternate expression, which can be used for a number of different encounters with Tito, or you could go for the part of the scene where we first see her going up to Unkar Plutt in the movie. You could do the part that's not in the movie, that's in the script or in the book as well. There's lots of stuff that you can do here. And here's the battle droid all fixed up as your little bonus figure, which is perfectly good and useful for other stuff. So there's plenty here for me to like and very little to dislike. It's got a lot of displayability, collectability with the figures and the builds, and play value as well. It just ticks all of the boxes. The price to part ratio is also very reasonable, although the total price compared to kind of the volume of total stuff that you get or that you see when you build this does feel a little bit on the high side. However, you know, there has to be something that gives, and they include so many parts, even though many of them are small, still, you know, the price to part ratio really drives the overall price. Lots of small details requires lots of parts, and you have to pay for those parts. If you have anything that you would like to say about this set, please do go ahead and leave your thoughts in a comment on the video down below. Thank you for watching. I appreciate your time. I appreciate your feedback if you're going to leave any, and I hope to have a chance to talk to you again very soon.